गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू आवर ऑनलाइन क्लास। दिस इज योर थर्ड पीरियड एंड द सब्जेक्ट इज सोशल साइंस। स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे आई बिगिन दिस वीडियो विथ ए कोट। हियर इज द कोट, challenge come not to depress or get you down but to master, to grow and to unfold your abilities. I repeat, challenges come not to depress or to get you down but to master, to grow and to unfold your abilities. Now, students, today I brought one word for you, new word for you. And the today's word of the day is forte. Forte, F-O-R-T-E. See, the spelling is F-O-R-T-E, but the pronunciation is forte. In parts of speech, this word is given the position of noun. So it is a noun. The word forte is a noun in parts of speech. Now the meaning of the word is one's strong point. One's strong point. Thank you, friends. Now let us move to our subject. Students, in the previous week, we studied the civics, the chapter 2, federalism, and in that chapter we have studied about the center-state relations and the diversity of languages in India. Also, we have started the last topic, that is decentralization in India. There in the topic, the last topic, decentralization in India, we have studied up to what are local governments. Up to there we have studied. So today in this video, I will cover the remaining part of this topic. Okay, students? Fine. Now, what is meant by decentralization of power, or what is meant by local self-governments? Generally, decentralization of power means the delegating of power, the distribution of power to the local bodies or the local self-government institutions is called decentralization. I mean delegating the power. However, in our textbook, he has given, when power is taken away, from central and state governments, and the same power is given to what? The local governments, then that is called decentralization. I repeat, according to textbook, when power is taken from central government and state governments, and that power, when it is given to the local self-governments, that is called decentralization of power, or I can say decentralization. Fine. The basic idea behind decentralization, what will be the basic idea behind decentralization is, listen, that there are large number of problems and issues which have been better settled at the local level. I'll tell you what is the idea behind decentralization of power. Let me tell you. Generally, we have two types of government, central government and state government. And local level, we are having our district level, gram level, I mean village level, city and town level. So, whenever there is any problem in a village or in a town or in a city, the people of that village, town and city, they have to approach to the state governments. Sometimes they approach directly to the central government to solve their problems. And it is very difficult to the central government to hear and to come from Delhi to that village level to study the problem. First they will come, suppose the local people reported, they sent a report to central government for any problem. The problem reached, it took some time, the problem is studied. Then a team will come to that particular local level, they will study the problem, again they will go back to the central government, they will do the analysis, they will find out the solutions, again then they will send the funds, then the work will be started here and the problem will be solved. In this process, lot of time is been taken and the burden of the government also will be increased. Similarly, whenever any problem is there in the city or town level, if you approach to the state governments, you know states are bigger, and we studied in the previous chapter, some states are even bigger than many of the European countries. So it will become very difficult to the state governments to look at each and every village, every town and every city, their problems. So once we refer the local problem to the state government, again same, it will take some time to reach the problem. There they'll discuss the problem, a team will come to see the problem, they'll make the report, the report will be sent back to the state government, again they'll do the analysis, then they'll find out the possible solutions, then the allotment of money to solve the problem, again the people will come, a team will come, they'll try to solve the problem. This entire process will take. So hence it is very time consuming, time taking, and the burden of the state governments also will be more. They may not concentrate. So what is said here? The main idea behind the decentralization of power is that local people, they knows their problem in a better manner than the state governments and the central government. Local people, either village level or town level or city level, they know their problems better than the state and the central governments. Local people can solve their problems better than the central government, state government. Next, if local people will solve their problems, then the expenditure part also will be less when compared when it is solved by the state and central government. Because the problem is local level. Local people have better idea about their problems. What are the causes for the problems? How it can be solved? That too, the expenditure part to solve the problem will be less. Moreover, when local people are able to solve their problem by themselves at local level with less expenditure and in a better manner without depending upon the state and central governments, then naturally the burden on the central state government also will be reduced, so that they can focus on some other issues, state level issues or national level issues, or state and national level development they can concentrate. So this is the main idea. That's why the government, the Indian constitution, decided to give some power to the local bodies, to the local self-government institutions, so that they can solve their problems better manner, easier manner, with less expenditure. Local people knows their problem in a better manner than the state and central government, etc. So in this way, the decentralization power was done. Okay, next one. I repeat, the basic idea behind decentralization is that there are large number of problems and issues which are best settled at the local level. People have better knowledge of problems in their localities. I know my problem. I know my area problems better than the state government, central government. I know how it can be solved easier way at lesser expenditure. They also have better ideas, okay, on where to spend money, how to spend money, how to manage things more efficiently. They know better than the state and central governments. Moreover, one more thing I forgot to say, if some power is being given to the local self-government institutions or local self-bodies, then one way we can give the chance to the local people to participate in governmental activities. I mean, local people can get an opportunity to participate in all the governmental activities. When local people will participate, then they'll get some political education. They'll get experience. Suppose local cell village panchayat are started at the village level. Suppose panchas are elected, sarpanch is elected. Sarpanch will work for 5 years. Then you'll get some political experience. You'll get political knowledge. Then it will help him further to contest for MLA, MP, etc. So it helps in giving political education to the local people. It gives a chance to the local people to participate in the governmental activities. Yes. Besides at the local level, it is possible for people to directly participate in decision making. Moreover, if you want to take any decisions on any problem, we have to wait for state government assent, consent. We have to wait for central government assent and consent. But the same thing, if you start in local level, local bodies, then the local people can gather easily on one fine day, on a pre-decided day. They'll discuss the problem, they find out the solution, and they can solve the problems in more efficient manner. Okay. So it gives an opportunity to the local people to participate in decision making. This also helps to inculcate a habit of democratic participation. When you start local bodies, when you make decentralization power, then it gives a chance to the people for what? You feel that we are doing democratic participation. We are participating in our democracy. That feel will be there in the people. Local government is the best way to realize one's important principle of democracy. If you give power to the local people, local bodies, local institutions, then we can say the true democracy is established. Democracy means what? Of the people, by the people, for the people, like that. Of for by. Now I can say the definition also changed. Of the people, for the people, by the people, not to the people. The government at the doorsteps of the local people. Now, the need for decentralization. Why there is a need for decentralization was recognized in our Indian Constitution. The need for decentralization of power was recognized in our Indian Constitution. Okay, since then there has been several attempts. Several attempts are made to decentralize power to the level of villages and towns or cities, I can say. So the need for decentralization power was recognized in the Indian Constitution. Several attempts were made in the Indian Constitution to decentralize the power, and finally the power was given to village level and town level. Panchayats in villages. Where do you find panchayats? Panchayats are generally found in village level. Similarly, municipalities are found in what? Urban areas. Panchayats are found in villages and rural areas. Panchayats are found in villages and rural areas, whereas municipalities are found in urban areas. Now, panchayats are set up in villages and municipalities in urban areas were set up in all the states. In all the states, this system was started. Again, I'll repeat. In village level, we have gram panchayats or village panchayats. Same thing in towns, in urban areas here. Urban means town areas. We have municipalities. Municipalities means what? Nagar Palika in Hindi. This Nagar Palika or municipalities in towns. In towns. Whereas municipal corporations, in Hindi you call Nagar Nigam, they are found in cities. So now you tell me, in Jagdalpur, what is there? Municipality or municipal corporation? Yes, it is municipal corporation. We have Nagar Nigam here. Now, but these were directly under the control of state governments. All the local self-government institutions, either village panchayat or mandal parishad, I mean some villages together will form one mandal. So their mandal parishad will be there, or block level. Again, few mandal parishads will form what? Jila panchayat. So village panchayat, mandal parishad, jila panchayat. These three are in the level of rural local cell government. Whereas in urban areas and towns we are having municipalities, and cities we are having municipal corporations. So both are going like this. In rural areas, three stages are there: village level, mandal level, and jila level. Whereas in urban areas, towns and cities. Okay. Now, these local cell government institutions, either rural local cell government institutions or urban local cell government institutions, all are under the direct and control of state government. They work under the control of state governments. Elections to these local cell governments were not held regularly. Generally, they have to be held every 5 years. But what we have seen, that the elections for Gram Panchayat, Village Mandal Parishad, Jila Panchayat, okay, municipalities, municipal corporations are not held regularly. Actually, they have to be held regularly, but they are not held regularly. Local governments did not have any powers or resources of their own. I repeat once again, local governments did not have any powers or resources of their own. It does not mean that the sarpanch is not having any power. It does not mean that the jila panchayat or chairman is not having any power. It does not mean that mayor of the city is not having any power. They are having power, but generally, okay, they may not make any changes in the government. Okay, now thus there was a little decentralization in effective terms. Namesake, we are telling local cell government institutions are given power through decentralization, but actually regular elections are not taking place in these local bodies. Moreover, in actual terms, they are not having power or control over resources. Now, major steps. Now, whatever paragraph I am reading now, it is one of the question answer. It is one of the question answer. You better underline or listen carefully. This is very, very important. Major steps towards decentralization was taken in 1982. Underline that one. So, when the major steps started in India in 1992. So, major steps towards decentralization was taken in 1992. So, according to the step which was taken in 1992, what are the things will happen? What things are decided? Listen, number one. The constitution was amended to make the third tier. So, 1992. The constitution was amended. Amended means changed. To make the third tier of democracy more powerful and effective. So, a major step was taken in 1992, and through this step, what happened? It was decided, the Indian Constitution was amended to make the third tier of democracy, that is local state government institutions, to make more powerful and effective. Now, so what are the steps that were taken in 1992? Listen. Now it is constitutionally mandatory. Now it became mandatory, means what? Compulsory. Now it is constitutionally mandatory to hold regular elections to local bodies, local cell government institutions. In 1992, it was decided that regular elections to be held for local cell body institutions, for local cell government institutions. That was decided, first one. Second one, seats were reserved. Sarpanch, Upsarpanch, or a mayor, or chairman, all this. The seats were reserved in the elected bodies as the executive heads of these institutions for the scheduled caste and scheduled tribe and other backward classes. So local self-government institutions, listen students, in local self-government institutions, some seats are reserved for SC, scheduled caste, SC, scheduled tribe, and OBC, other backward classes. So the main purpose is to give them what? Some power, some reservation, so that they'll participate, they'll win the election, and they'll hold the political position or public office. So seats were reserved in the elected bodies. In whatever election is there, in that elected body, some seats are reserved for SCSC, STSC, and OBCs. Next, at least 1/3 of all the positions are reserved for women. One more thing, another reservation. Apart from SC, apart from ST, apart from OBC, 1/3 seats are also reserved for what? Women candidates. I can say it is through local self bodies women were empowered. The powers were given to them. So at least 1/3 of the positions are reserved for women candidates. Next one. An independent institution called the State Election Commission. An independent institution called the State Election Commission has been created in each state to conduct panchayat and municipal elections. Very, very important. An independent institution. Okay. Called the State Election Commission. Called the State Election Commission has been created. Has been created in each state to conduct regular elections for panchayats and municipal elections. Next, the state governments are required to share some powers and revenue with the local self bodies. In 1992, a major step was also taken that some of the power of the state government should be shared with the local self government institutions, and some income of the state government should be diverted to the local self body institutions or local self government institutions so that they can work, they can spend money on various works. Repeat. The state governments are required to share some powers and revenue, some income of theirs with the local government bodies. The nature of sharing varies from state to state. One thing is there. The nature of sharing power, the nature of sharing revenue by the state to the local self bodies varies from state to state. In some states, more power is given, more revenue is given. Some state, less is given. It is not same in all the states. Next one. The rural local government is popularly known as what? Namely as Panchayat Raj. Another name. This you can underline. One more question. Rural local government is popularly known as. Rural local government is popularly known as by the name of Panchayat or Panchayati Raj. Each village. You know where is Panchayat Raj? Where is village Panchayat? Where is Panchayat Raj? Where is village Panchayat? Listen carefully. Very, very important. Now entire parish very, very important. Each village or a group of villages, either individual village or 2-3 villages. Okay. Each village or a group of villages in some states has a gram panchayat. Sometimes if the villages are small, suppose the population of the village is very less. When the population of the village is very less, 100 people, 200 people, then 2-3 villages together will have one village panchayat, one gram panchayat. So that's why I said, either individual village, if the village is big, or if the village having less, very less population, then 2-3 villages will together will have one village panchayat, the gram panchayat. This is a council, group of members. So this is a council, consists of several ward members. In a village panchayat, in a gram panchayat, there will be some ward members. And the ward members number will be decided based on the population of the village. Based on the population of the village, the number of ward members will be decided. Actually, the entire village will be divided into number of wards. Some streets like wards. And from each ward, one ward member will be elected by the members of that ward. Okay, repeat. The entire village will be divided into number of wards. And from each ward, one ward member will be elected. And he is elected by the members of that ward. The people of that ward. Member means what? Not all people. Those people who have crossed 18 years and above, who are eligible for voting, they only will vote to elect this ward member, not the children like you. Next. This is a council consists of several ward members, often called panch. These ward members, we can call them as what? Panch also. Panch. Ward members of gram panchayat are called panch. Another important question. The ward members in a gram panchayat is called what? Panch. And a president will be there for every village, a president, or we can say sarpanch. In some state they are called president, in some other state they are called what? Sarpanch or village headman. We can say village headman, sarpanch or president. So, and a panch or president will be there. Now, they are directly elected by all the adult population living in the ward, in that ward. All the adult means who have crossed 18 years of age. So, all the adult population of that ward will choose these panches or this panch. In that ward or village. Next. It is the decision making body. This gram panchayat is a decision making body. The gram panchayat is the decision making body for the entire village. The gram panchayat will take all the decisions related to the village. The panchayat works under the control under control and overall supervision of Gram Sabha. Another thing, Gram Panchayat is different than Gram Sabha. Listen carefully. Gram Panchayat is different from Gram Sabha. Gram Panchayat means what? All the ward members whom you call Panch plus one head, Sarpanch or President, together is called what? Gram Panchayat. And they will take all the decisions of the village. They will carry out all the works of the village. Now, and how they are elected? They are elected by the adult population of each ward. Now, at the same time, the Panchayat, whatever I told you, the Panchayat, this group of members, the Panchayat works under the control of, or under the supervision of Gram Sabha. This Gram Sabha is bigger than Gram Panchayat. Gram Sabha. Now, what is Gram Sabha? The entire village population together, is called Gram Sabha. It includes all the adults, aged people, young people, etc. So, all the voters in the village, all the voters means what? Voting rate is given to above the age of 18. So, all the voters in that village, adult, all the voters, that too adult, or all adults only will get a vote. So, all the voters in the village are the members of this Gram Sabha. Now, one important thing. Suppose I am living in Gram Kalipur, near your village, so near your school. I am living in Kalipur. Kalipur is a village, suppose. Now, I am living there, but my name is not there in the voter list of that village. And I am not taking part in the election of ward members in that village. But I am staying there. So, I may not be called as a member of Gram Sabha. Okay, remember that. So, all the voters in that village, only voters of the village only comes under the category of Gram Sabha. But all the people are living in the village. Suppose you are living, I am living. Suppose you are living, you are not having right to vote. I am living, but I am having right to vote somewhere else. I am only living there, I am the resident. So, we will not include it in the Gram Sabha. It has, now this Gram Sabha will meet twice or thrice in a year. The Gram Sabha will meet twice or thrice in a year. And in that meeting, what they will do? They will give approval, assent, the budget of Gram Panchayat. I mean, whatever works are done by the Gram Panchayat till date, they will review all the works. They will check how much money is spent, how much money the Gram Panchayat spent on each work. So, the review of their works, how much budget was spent on them, how much money spent on them. Next one, what are the other tasks which has to be taken care in that village? What are the other problems which are there in the village that will be brought into the notice of Gram Panchayat? So, in this way, the Gram Sabha will meet twice or thrice in a year. I'm sorry.